in the, Colonial Museum in Lokoja in Bukite. It's in an absolutely terrible state. It's one of those colonial houses on stilts in a raised up wooden houses, but it's actually positively dangerous because there was a hole in the wooden floor through which somebody could quite easily have fallen. I was in Sokoto recently, and I went to the historical department, which was also a museum of the university there. And they have archives, really interesting archives from the colonial era, but they are in an absolutely shocking state of repair. Nobody goes there. The visitor's book in the museum in Carmel that I went to had about, three people in the past week. So, there's a lack of investment. I don't know what it is. There's history. I'm not talking, by the way, about colonial history, which is an important part of Nigerian history, but it's a tiny, tiny, tiny proportion of Nigerian history. I'm talking about the cultural diversity, the richness of all of the different ethnic groups here and how that needs to be preserved. So, I think artists have a role to raise the profile of that. And if you agree with me, to pull it out, because it's about, of course it's about money, but it's also about the political will to invest in arts and culture here. And quite interesting with the ministry here is the Ministry of Information, Culture, and...
It used to be National Orientation.
What does National Orientation mean? Okay, don't tell me you worked in that ministry. But that, I think that's really interesting. So culture and information, why is culture put together in information? The guy who's running culture is also